A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th May, on the front page you have Supreme Court agrees with Election Commission on clean chit to Modi Shah speeches. It asks Congress MPs to file fresh petition against comments violating poll code. So this is the Supreme Court judgment. It agreed with the contention that the clean chit given for the speeches may be right or wrong, but the court certainly cannot examine the merit of its decisions on the basis of PIL petition. So that's what the Supreme Court said. So because the PIL petition was filed earlier when the Election Commission had not given clean chits, now the clean chits are being challenged. So the Supreme Court has asked them to file a new PIL petition. Next is, Iran says it will not honor nuclear curbs. So Iran has said it has stopped respecting limits on its nuclear activities agreed in the 2015 deal with major powers until they find a way to bypass renewed US sanctions. Then on below you have, stick to July 31 deadline for final NRC, says Supreme Court. So the final NRC will be done by 31st July is the deadline, and though the elections are going on, Supreme Court has asked them to stick to the deadline and act with wise discretion while dealing with objectors. So this is the NRC coordinator Pratik Haleja who has been given this direction by the Supreme Court to act with wise discretion. So there are objections. Objectors are those who are objecting to somebody else being added into the NRC. They are objecting that no, this person should not be added. So there are objectors as well as claimants. Claimants are those who are claiming that though they have been excluded, they themselves are claiming that we should be added. So there are two types of such applications which have been taken in, that is claimants and objections, objectors. Then on page 4 you have Belinder drying up as DDA expedites waste via work. So this is regarding Belinder Lake in Bangalore. So here the murky waters have receded from the banks of Bangalore as Bangalore Development Authority has lowered the water level to rebuild the waste here. So pollution, you know, to reduce waste and clean pollutions here, the steps have been taken by Bangalore Development Authority. Belinder Lake has prominently been in news because it caught fire because of froth being developed because of industrial waste and even domestic waste being drained into the lake, because of which frothing was taking place. The way frothing takes place when you use washing powder with water. So, and then it caught fire because of those chemicals too. On page 7 you have ASI, Archaeological Survey of India, identifies rare Indian artifacts seized from smugglers. So it has sent 2-member expert teams to US, United States, which will examine nearly 100 antique objects. You can see these ideas from Gupta period to terracotta objects of Harappan culture, and a range of Indian antiquities and artifacts have been smuggled by Subhash Kapoor. So this has been identified by Archaeological Survey of India. So team will now go to US to examine these artifacts. Then below you have Cyclone Fani tears down artist's village in Odisha. So this is regarding Pattachitra. You should know that, you know, this is the art form from Odisha. So a traditional cloth based scroll painting. So it generally narrates Krishna Leela, you know, and such mythological stories as such. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Alternative Dreams. So this is regarding an effort being made towards forming a third front post the Lok Sabha elections, means a front without Congress or BJP. So regional parties have tried earlier too, and one more attempt is being made to build a third front. And this is Circle of Life. So this is regarding an article which was there, a UN report, in which, you know, global assessment report, in which it was stated that millions of species would go extinct if the way humans use natural resources presently continues. So in a matter of decades, you can see 1 million species could go extinct. So this talks of, the editorial talks of how biodiversity assessment must be factored in into all economic activity. That's very important. The lead article is Begusarai, metaphor of a secular crisis. So in Begusarai, Kanhaiya Kumar standing for elections where you have a BJP candidate and a Muslim candidate contesting as such too. So here it is said, for the minorities, secularism is a survival tool. For the elite, it is an ideology. And he says, and the article says, in caste competition, it could be a tactic. Then below you have a travesty of justice. So this says, judges must not reduce the institution to a private club, whereby they are the last word on their own colleague. So this is regarding the in-house committee of the Supreme Court, which gave a clean chit to the CJI and has not given the report out in the open to public, neither to the alleger, the female staffer who had leveled those allegations. So this is a travesty of justice, as you know, as reasoned out in this article. And then on op-ed page you have a wake-up call on proprietary seeds. So this article talks of how India can shift its agriculture from high yield ideal to high value one. We don't want a high yield variety, but a variety which gives high value. So this is being emphasized on here. It is in the context of potato cultivation with respect to PepsiCo and the Gujarat farmers case too. And then you have the anatomy of a marginalized region. So it says, with a high percentage of Muslims, Bihar Simachal region frames issues of representation and welfare. Then this is taking tension seriously. So this says, a true strategic partnership between India and US remains elusive. So this is the article on India-US strategic relations, which actually are elusive presently. On international page you have, US threatens to impose more sanctions on Iran. So it has advised European countries against doing business with Iran. Russia and China have reiterated their opposition to these punitive steps of USA. So now USA is threatening more sanctions. So this is the entire detail given here regarding even Iran's commitments under the deal, the JCPOA, Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, and its oil production and the GDP growth as well. Then this is, Asia Bibi leaves Pakistan for Canada. So Asia Bibi is a Christian woman from Pakistan who has been acquitted by the Supreme Court of blasphemy last year. So she's finally now leaving Pakistan for Canada. Then on business page you have, firms missing from database will not affect GDP calculations. So, shell companies in Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA 21, submitting balance sheets regularly are very much part of measurement, says former statistician. And this is, income support Uday driving fiscal slippages. So, this is the RBI, which has voiced its concern over government schemes such as inputs, minimum support, income support, revival packages for power distribution companies, loan waivers. So all this will lead to fiscal slippages. The fiscal deficit would not be kept under control. And on the last page you have, India's newest pit viper found in Arunachal. So a team of herpetologists are hoping to study its diet and breeding pattern and habitat too. So this is a pit viper, you can see the snake, found in Arunachal Pradesh. And the last news is, World Health Organization for eliminating industrially produced trans fats by 2023. So it will partner with International Food and Beverages Alliance to work on this target. So that is it. These are the news items. For detailed coverage of current affairs and PDF for current affairs, you can visit our website and download it from there. The website is aashar.com. Thank you.